I'm gonna pull out the broom.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's coming to an end tonight. Where's your head out on this series?
Man.
I mean, I could go so many places with you, but let me just jump into it.
Let's jump into it.
Did you ever expect that this team would be on the verge of getting swept?
Well, I'm a LeBron fan, so I was optimistic. I wanted them to win. Deep in my heart, I kind of knew the Warriors would beat them. The Warriors should have won last year, too.
I agree.
And it's hard for me to say that because, like I said, I'm a LeBron fan. So the Warriors should have won last year.
Do you think the Draymond Phantom penile kick was the reason why they didn't win? That was a turning point.
That was a turning point. If Draymond played, the Warriors win, you know, 3-1, 4-1.
Yep.
4-1, absolutely.
And then LeBron doesn't have a championship in Cleveland.
LeBron will not have it. He would have gotten there, what, twice?
Yes.
Three times.
Yes.
But, you know, there would have been a Warriors three-peat. They're too good. They're 3 years ahead of every other team. They play the right way.
Mm.
It's not difficult to beat. You know, you practice hard in the summertime and you play the right way.
And you know, one of the things that I think is most impressive about that Warriors team is the unselfishness that they didn't need to learn. They just had it.
They had it, yeah.
So 4-0.
Right.
My new thing is this, Metta. No longer mention Michael Jordan without taking an hour-long grace period before you mention LeBron James. There's no more comparison. And if you're going to say Kobe Bean Bryant, you need to take a 30-minute grace period before you mention LeBron James. The comparisons, in my opinion, are stupid. You must get asked all the time. You played against these guys. What is your opinion on this whole LeBron, MJ, LeBron, Kobe? Where do they stand? If you're at the park, you're playing pickup.
Right.
Life's on the line.
Okay.
Okay, and you need to pick those. You're not playing. You're picking the team. So so it's not like you're going to think of it in matchups terms.
Okay.
You're coaching the team. You got Kobe, you got LeBron, and you got MJ. You get the first pick. Who's your guy?
Kobe.
Over both of them?
Absolutely.
Why?
Come on.
Kobe's he's a killer. He has...
Jordan's no friendly guy.
I love Jordan. Jordan is my favorite... One of my favorite players. B.J. Armstrong is my favorite player.
B.J. Armstrong is your favorite player?
That's amazing. Pool.
That's amazing.
B.J. Armstrong.
I don't see any similarities between Ron Artest when you played and B.J. Armstrong. I don't see the influence of B.J. Armstrong, but let's stay on this.
Yeah, let's not talk about B.J. He's not. He shouldn't be the topic of Michael Jordan and Kobe.
And isn't B.J. Armstrong, doesn't he have something to do with like Derek? Isn't he Derek Rose's agent?
I heard that years ago, but I don't know anymore.
Okay, because I really don't want to talk about B.J. Armstrong then. Go ahead.
But, you know, I feel like Kobe, I would pick Kobe. LeBron, very unique, you know, but you got to give credit to the general managers and the ownership. So with Kobe, you got to give some credit to, you know, Dr. Buss. And with Jordan, you got to give some credit to Jerry Krause.
Right.
LeBron, everybody's saying he's the general manager right now.
He is.
but I feel like, you know, it's hard to compare. LeBron needs some new players. I'm sorry to say that. But he needs some new players.
On that team.
Yeah, he needs some endurance. He needs some people who's playing with confidence. I don't get why I don't see more guys going 0 for 10, 0 for 20. They're not giving themselves a shot. You know, they're not shooting the ball. They're not being aggressive.
Why?
You know, they're only doing it some game. I don't know.
I think
maybe
they're neutered.
Confidence.
I think like J.R. Smith, and particularly J.R. Smith, he's neutered. Like J.R. Smith is a volume shooter.
Right.
J.R. is going to shoot you in, shoot you out. Game 7, listen, LeBron's block is the iconic thing.
Of course.
But J.R. won them that game.
He was huge. He was huge, and I want to see more of that from J.R.
What happened to him?
I think he was waiting to see if let the game settle in.
He doesn't know what to do no more.
I think he was waiting for the game to come. Instead of just going to get it, and you know, and Iman too. I want to see Iman.
He's done. Listen, you know
I
want
to see him play better. He's not playing well right now.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and audience.
If you like that video, be sure to download our app. Don't have any memory on your phone? Let's start to delete some of those slow-mo videos you have. And you know which ones I'm talking about.